Now that we have our first project set up, I'd like to quickly go over the RPG Maker MV interface before we get into actually creating our game. I have our project open that we created in the last video, and we'll use it to go over what's included within the interface and what each section is used for. The first area most people notice is the map view, this area here. The map view is where you can see the current map you are working on. The map is made up of tiles, which you can place by selecting a tile and left-clicking on the map. You can also add events by switching to the event mode and double-clicking the tile where you'd like the event to be placed. Events are what adds functionality to your game. You add them all here in the map view. You can zoom in and out on the map by holding down the control button and scrolling the mouse wheel up or down. That looks a little better. Now we can see a little more detail on our map. Next, we have the menu bar here at the top of the interface. The file menu lets us create, save, and open our projects. We can perform edit actions on the items added to our map, like copy, cut, and paste. A lot of the functionality of the stuff in the menu bar we'll cover later, but we can switch between map and event modes. In the map mode, you can place tiles and visually design your map. And with the event mode, you can place event tiles, which act like triggers, firing off depending on how you want them to perform. We can set our draw mode to either place single tiles, place in a cluster in a rectangle shape or oval shape, or fill. We can also scale the map up and down like we did with the mouse wheel, except here we can click to zoom in or out. One of the most important things about the menu bar is the tools menu. From here you can access every aspect of your game in the database. The database contains everything, your characters, weapons, armor, spells, items, etc. You can add further functionality to your games with the plugin manager, or create new characters with a character generator. We can also playtest our game from within the menu bar, or access the help files. Below the menu bar is the toolbar. The toolbar does pretty much everything the menu bar does, but they are represented by an icon instead of contained in a drop-down menu. This can help you work a little faster when you already know what you're trying to do. Here, we have the file controls, new project, open project, and save project. Going right, we have the edit functions. We can set the map mode. The drawing modes are here. Scale. The game tools, such as the database. And we can playtest the game. On the left side of the interface, we've got the tile palette, where we can select a tile that we want to place on the map. Underneath the palette, there are four tabs, A, B, C, and R. A, B, and C each have visual tiles that can be placed on the map, while R defines regions, which are useful for mapping out areas with enemy encounters of varying difficulty, causing damage when you walk over certain areas, and other things like that. We'll cover that more in the future. Below the tile palette, we have the map list, where you can find all of the maps we have for the project we're working on. In this case, we just have one. The default starting map, map 001. You can add new maps to the project by right-clicking inside the map list and selecting New. We'll cover the creation of new maps later, but let's go ahead and just add this new map to our project. Now we have two maps, and we can switch back and forth between the two. If you want to delete one of your maps, just right-click it and select Delete. Last, we have the status bar at the bottom of the interface. The status bar gives you various information about what you're working on, like the current map, map size, and zoom level. If you hover over a tile on the map, the status bar will tell you the position of the tile that you're hovering over, in this case, 1612. That covers the RPG Maker interface and where everything is located. Next, we can start to dive into our project and see what we can really do with RPG Maker. Now that you understand where everything is and what it's used for, you'll be able to get up and running much faster.